What's good, everybody? This is your man DJ TiVo from the Legendary Lords crew here to break down another Mikey Sutton exclusive. Something on the supernatural tip. But if you're new to the channel, make sure you hit that subscribe button, bump that reminder bell, and like this video for content like this as we'll be dropping more scoops and follow-up videos after I've dropped this one to you. So this is something on the supernatural tip. Let's get right to it, boys and girls. The man who hunts vampires meets a woman with her head on fire. No, that's not the punchline of a joke or the beginning of a joke, but it is something that's coming to the MCU. And her name is Alejandro Jones, and she's the next Ghost Rider in the MCU. Kevin Feige wants to refresh and Ghost Rider for the movies, and the current plan is to use Alejandro Jones instead of Robbie Reyes in the theatrical films. Discussions have begun to introduce her as Jones in the first Blade movie. But the situation is still fluent as the film, while greenlit, is still in the conceptual stage. And we all know at San Diego Comic-Con, Mahershala Ali called up Kevin Feige and said, yo, I want to play Blade. That put those plans into motion, so they're still very early in the project. We had Blade appearing in the Hulu series as part of the Spirits of Vengeance, the Midnight Suns, and all that good stuff before Feige plucked him out and decided to put him in the MCU on the big screen. The talks are casting either an African-American or a Latina as Jones, with Blade meeting her while freeing young women forced into prostitution. Now, this is actually taken directly out of the comic books. It would be shocking to me that they would actually use this storyline because it's a bit dark, but it does have its roots in the comic books. Alejandro Jones first appeared as her father was, his last name is Jones, that's all we know, but he was a human trafficker. Her mother is a Mexican national. All we know is at an early age, she was saved by Adam. Believe it or not, there's a character in the comics in the 616. His name is just Adam. He's the son of the one above all, basically, essentially God's son, Adam and Eve. There you go. She was saved, brought to Nicaragua, and trained in a temple to become the next Ghost Rider. In the comics, unfortunately, she just recently passed away in 2019 under the absolute carnage symbiote of Vengeance Number One, where she sacrificed herself, and her spirit lives on, though. She did possess a girl's body named Amara, who helped fight off the symbiote, Carnage, the evil version of her. And that's in Ghost Rider Volume 7, Number 3. I know it's a lot to get to because the Ghost Rider mythos, there's quite a bit, especially lately, because you got Johnny Blaze as the ruler of hell now. Zarathros got kicked out of hell by Mephisto. So there's a lot of moving parts, especially in the supernatural world, if you haven't been reading the comics lately. And we'll try to break it all down to you on next Wednesday's show to talk about what the current comics are and what the current reads are. I think my man Manimal has been reading the current Ghost Rider run. If you haven't, they've been doing a lot of interesting stuff to it. So there's a lot of stuff to pull from it and recently that they could adapt to the big screen. The character's been around since the 70s in the Bronze Age with Marvel Spotlight Number 5 with the first appearance of Johnny Blaze. But there's been Johnny Blaze, Danny Ketch, Alejandro Jones, Cosmic Ghost Rider. There's been four or five different versions of Ghost Rider. So the character has a rich history in the Marvel comics. The two will project quite a visual. Dark heroes on their motorcycles, one engulfed in flames, cruising the city at night. Close your eyes and imagine that for a minute. Blade and a female Ghost Rider kicking some butt. We'll get more for you on Wednesday show, and we'll break down all of it as much as we can and talk about the comics that could be affected by this news. But going forward, looks like we're going to get ourselves some Ghost Rider. Don't know when, but it looks like it's going to be in Blade. Don't know when Blade is coming out, but she's going to be appearing in the Blade film. So we got that to look forward to. Marvel's doing a lot of cool supernatural stuff. It's a good time to be a fan of the horror side of the Marvel Universe. So till Wednesday, boys and girls, keep digging in them long boxes. Peace out.